that's a basic 12-bar blues that we're going to learn today. Before we do that, there are a lot of things that you can do from that. So I'll just give you a quick example. So it doesn't have to stay that basic. And you can do more sort of improv stuff over all the other chord shapes and all that. First thing we're going to do is we're going to learn 12 bar. If you don't know what a 12 bar is, we're going to go over that quickly. And then we'll get to the chords and the various ways you can play that, and you can improve on that and improvise over it and add some of your scales and all that sort of business. Great, here we go. First thing we're going to do is just quickly draw out a 12 bar. Looks like this. If you know what a 12 bar is, then don't worry about it. If you don't know what a 12 bar is, you can have a look-see. Basic 12 bar, they're 12 bars all the way through. The first four stay the same. The next two are going to be different. So is this one. And these two are going to be different from those other two. So that's what you've got. That's a basic pattern for a 12 bar. We're not going to go into the on how to arrange the chords and all that this lesson, but we'll get onto that further later on. So we're going to put all of these open boxes as an E. So we're playing in the key of E. This gets an A. And these we're going to put in a B7. This is just a very basic 12 bar structure. You can go ahead and screen grab that if you haven't done 12 bar blues before. Right, so we're going to have a look at the first bar, which is the E. And one of those E's is going to look like this. That's one E. Alright, so the first one looks like that. Second fret, first fret, second chord, fourth fret, second fret, and then fifth fret, fourth fret, back down to the second one, which is fourth fret and second fret. So now what we've got is we've got four E's, so we'll be doing this four times. The picking for that now. Second chord is the A, which is going to look like this. So you've got your second frets, fourth and third, fifth and fifth, fourth and third. And we're going to play that twice because there's two E's. So what first A's. So the first A, second A. Then you've got two E's again, so we go through the first part. Then the last row we hit the B. We're not going to be playing that B7, that's a new basic 12 bar. You're going to be playing this B. That's it there. Then we're going to go to an A. Then we play the A. Playing an E again, and then lastly a B. And you either resolve and finish in E, or you carry on and you go straight back to it, and you play the whole sequence through. Right, so go back to the beginning, have a look at it played in the beginning of the video, just so you can get an idea of the flow, and you can watch some of the chords. So the chords I'm going to draw out for you now, and you can just take a good look at those chords. I'm also going to include a tab, so you, if you can read tabs, you can just have a look at that as well. Right, so here it is. You've got your 12 bar over here. The way you play it is you play this E, this E, this E, this E, this E, A, A, E, E, B, A, E, B. I've shown you the chords on the guitar, but we're going to have a look at them in the diagram now as well. First E, you play these four chords. You can go back and have a look on the guitar how they're done as well. So once you've done this set of four chords, you move on to the next E, which is again these four chords, then this E, these four chords, and the last E, these four chords. Then you move on to your A, and you play these four chords. And you're playing the A again, these four chords. E is over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You do it again, 1, 2, 3, 4. These two rows are identical. Then we're on to the B, and you're going to be playing these four chords. You'll notice this last chord here, we're changing to an A early. So for B, these four chords. For A, these four chords. You notice the chord change at the end again. And E, we're playing again, which is the same as these two. And the B, this last row here. What I would suggest is, have a look at all these chords and just find them on your guitar, then find these chords on your guitar, and so forth. So work out and find all your chords. And then we'll look at putting them back together again, which we've done earlier in the video. You can go ahead and screen grab this as well for your reference. Okay, so quick recap. What you're going to do is take your screen grab of the 12 bar and the chords, and just go through and learn all of those chords in their sort of grouping. So learn the E chords. Just practice using your fingers like that till you've got that. Then you do your A chords. And then you go through back to your E. And then you go into your B, which is straightforward, it's just those. And then you're doing that three times, so B, 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 A. And then you're going back to your A, which is going to be these three times, and then the open chord. And then back to your E, and then to your B again. Now, on that last B, before we go on to the picking and all that, on the last B, we're not going to be playing that same sort of count. We're going to be just picking through that chord. So I'll show you that in the picking part. All right, and that's the basic summary so far. Right, so this is the picking for your chords. On the first set of chords, the E's, you're going to be using this E string, the A string, and the D string. Like that. I'm going to work on the timing now as well. First chord, second chord, third chord, and fourth chord. And what you're going to do is you're going to use your thumb before each of those chords, and you're going to go a one, a two, a three, a four for this particular 12 bar. So a one, then you move to your next chord, a two, a three, a four, and it'll look and sound like this. And that's what you do for the E. Then onto your A, you're just going to take that exact same thing and move it down a string. So you're going A, D, and on your B. First chord, a one. Second chord, a two. Third chord, a three. And then a four again. And it's going to look and sound like this. And that's your A done. Then you're going back to your E, so we'll do that again, and you're only doing this twice this time. Right, now to the B chords. We're going to be using your A string, your G string, and your D. So now they're together. They were always separated, now they're together like that. And you're just going to do this three times. Then you're changing to that A. And you're going back to these two strings. So let's just do that again. That's your B done. And then it's back to the A. And the A we're going to do like this. Three times, and then the open chord. It is let's just show that again. Back to your E once. And then the last B. So you hold the B and you're gonna go one and a two and a three and a four. Or you can do that however you like. You can also do. And then you'll be going either resolving and finishing your song, or you will be carrying on with the 12 bar. So the last B chord, you can kind of do what you want. This is what I kind of do. So give that a go, mess around, play, and do whatever you like for that chord. And you can pick that like that, or you can just pick it straightforward like that. It really doesn't matter. Last chord again. If you're going back, you just got to get your back to the 12 bar, you just got to get your timing a little bit better and go straight back into the E. So and then you leave it there, and then you're going back to a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4. Let me show you that again. So that's basically it. Learn the chords, learn the picking on this side, and then just slowly work together, going through those separately. So your chord groups, learn to pick just the E, then learn to pick just the A, etc. And slowly put it together. Watch the beginning of the video again to get the actual clip and the how the 12 bar looks and sounds. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, you can visit the Sound of Art Cape Town, our Facebook page, and you can post questions and comments and all that sort of stuff. Thank you very much.